You know, Roderick, you know that I'm a learned man. You've seen my posts. Sure, they're a little typographically challenged, but when it comes to history, Rod Steele's the man. Now, we want to talk about a year and a month ago. Ruskin, Florida. The top of the card. Sedrick, I think this Super 8 shirt's going to walk off me because I haven't cleaned it yet strong. Top in the card. Now, what were you doing a year and a month ago? Well, you were right here in the middle of the Florida WrestlePlex, the premier professional wrestling outfit in the entire land. Thanks to him, you came up to Ron Neiman. You said, Ron, please, you got to get my boy in. Sedrick Strong, you got to let him in, please. He got him in. He made him a star.
I did make him a star.
Now, what's he want to do? He wants to come out here and he wants to talk about how he's this. I've been all over the world. What about Roger Strong? Everything he has in this company, you know. Mikey Tenderfoot. Flomo Joe Cynic, where you chop him 6-8 times and he did it once. I hooked you up. I brought you in. I know, fitting that tonight in Davies, you guys tonight, it's on, baby. Who's the champ? Not us yet. But...
Welcome, gentle viewers, to IPW Hardcore Television. I'm here joined by the returning Aaron Royale.
That's right, Mikey. I saw Ron Neiman. He left you in the lurch last week. You had to come out here by yourself. You did an all right job, kid, but I couldn't let that happen again. I knew Ron Neiman would be a no-show again, so I'm here to help you out.
You greedy bastards. There you see Shooting Star in the ring, Frankie Capone already in the ring, and we're about to introduce Mr. 630, Jerrelle Clark.
That's right, big three-way dance to open up this week of IPW Television. You actually teamed with this Shooting Star guy a few weeks back, Mikey Tenderfoot, in a six-man match along with the Bug. One of the opponents was Jerrelle Clark. And I tell you, you and Jerrelle Clark, two of the so-called baby faces here in IPW.
Most of the people in the IPW locker room, but sometimes you just have to go at it.
A rumor that he's actually the third nephew of Chicky Star, or as I believe, he was just a three-way dance coming up. You, Mr. 630, Jerrelle Clark, he's been all over the country lately. He's on
into a double hip toss. Another lock up there from Frankie Capone and Jerrelle Clark. Going in justifiably, they hate him.
Capone, he's put back together, Double Deuce Incorporated, with a huge swerve on Mark Zouk that nobody saw the ring. Oh, and it looks like a little bit of...
I don't get it anymore.
Oh, my. Frankie Capone is beating the hell out of some people. 630 as he rolls him over right there. Not going to get Frankie Capone nearly that easy.
Up at Jerrelle Clark, and there's the first back chop of the night, and there's the second.
Looking over, Shooting Star out there. Jerrelle Clark, he could bring someone to ringside. So could Shooting Star, but they got the...
Frankie Capone can't credit.
Shoot. Face, and as we're talking about that, a wrestling clinic going on inside the ring from Jerrelle Clark and Frankie Capone.
Shooting Star now starting to get back into the action after all the distractions from Canning keeping him out of this matchup. Jerrelle Clark whipped into the corner. Now Frankie Capone doesn't know what to do, doesn't know where to go. Shooting Star stands now making some sort of agreement with him, and Shooting Star going right to work on Jerrelle Clark. Look at Frankie Capone though, pushing him out of the way. He wants to get part of the action and dismantle this kid. Nice double back elbow.
Well, I tell you, we were talking about how will the fans react to Shooting Star. A whole lot of it depends on which wrestler he decided to target. He's targeted fan favorite Jerrelle Clark, so naturally, they're not going to like him one bit.
Shooting Star, though, will definitely go after Frankie Capone. He just wants to win here. He has no alliances with anybody. Although, maybe I'm wrong, maybe Frankie Capone and Double Deuce have recruited Shooting Star as to take out Jerrelle Clark.
That would be quite an addition.
Oh, nice flying head scissors for Jerrelle Clark.
There you see Richie Rich in the corner taking in all the action. He's even starting to get some Richie's rats down here in Davie. Oh, but talk about down there, kicking out the legs of Shooting Star. Oh!
Nice kick to the back of the head, a spinning kick right to the back of the head of Shooting Star. Jerrelle Clark now trying to go after Frankie Capone. Maybe he's going to go to take all three of these men out.
Let's see, Jerrelle Clark looking like he's going to climb the turnbuckles there, and this cannot be good for the three men standing on the outside of the ring.
Oh no, he's got it lined up. All men in position. Jerrelle Clark going to fly. Nice piñata, and he lands on his feet and acts like, yeah, that's right. I just landed on my feet. I'm tight. I'm down.
Big pimping, Jerrelle Clark.
Oh boy, did you have to go there?
I think I did.
Jerrelle Clark, very proud of himself. I'm very proud of him as well. That was a beautiful kick brought it to the outside to take out all three men. Now you got to see if he can get Frankie Capone or Shooting Star in the ring and get a pin up. A look at Shooting Star way ahead of the guy. Hits him with a nice drop kick.
tell you, if Shooting Star could get a win over Jerrelle Clark, that would be huge indeed. Jerrelle, a perennial contender for the cruiserweight title. Beautiful. And Shooting Star showing why he's one of the most talked about independent wrestlers both over in England and in AAA out on the west coast of this country. And Jerrelle Clark, and as I said, if he could get a
nice slider bomb, got a pin. Oh, and Shooting Star pulls him out. Look at
Smash. You've got to pretty much wear out.
Letting them get the pin, but honestly, can you blame him?
Obviously not. And here we go. Both men working over Jerrelle, defending against Naftali. And
oh, we've got a tremendous three-way going.
Numbers there, then going after each other. But once again, Jerrelle slap Shooting Star across the back. Oh. And this is IPW after all.
Leg Larry. Look at Richie Rich getting all in the way of the camera.
Richie Rich so excited, he doesn't even know where he is in the ring right now. Oh, but Shooting Star better know where. What in the world was that?
Frankie Capone trying to roll him over. Once it's too successful, Shooting Star is able to kick out because of the sloppy cover. Now it looks like they're going back to Jerrelle Clark and see if they can finish him off. Uh-oh. K5 hits it. Jerrelle Clark is out.
That's it. That's the finishing maneuver of Frankie Capone. Finished off many men. But again, Shooting Star is up. And Mikey, I know we've called you on more than one occasion the uninterested dancer. Shooting Star appears to be the uninterested wrestler at this moment.
Oh,
I have no clue what is in my thermos.
It's been going on for quite a time now. They're probably going to get it.
Anybody is.
Oh, no.
He's not giving. Oh!
The belly driver onto the back of the head of Frankie Capone, but he can't even.
What a cocky cover.
Oh, come on, Cannon. What are you doing, brother?
He was asking him what he wanted.
Frankie Capone returns. Richie Rich's ass. K-5! Jerrelle Clark taking out Frankie Capone to the outside. Going up to the top. He's got it lined up for Jerrelle Clark. Moving your winner. Hooks the lid hard. A nice death valley driver from Shooting Star, but that wasn't enough. Jerrelle Clark going up to the top and hitting the 630 as you see there.
Billy, come here. How would you like to be the first car in Japan? Yes, I
Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico. Commercials. Maybe I can make you a star, baby.
We're back with our second.
Up just a little bit short against Lex Lovett. He teamed up with Mikey.
Yes, I have a lot of respect for this guy. And he's gonna try and take.
Taken too well to the fans liking Norman Smiley. Seems to have a little bit of a different angle for me again.
Danny Doring. Nice shoulder block from Norman Smiley to start this match off. Take him over with a headlock takedown to control him.
Fans, your hardcore champion, Mideon.
Mideon hit on the mat. This guy's been working. Oh, it puts his head right
down here. Oh, and there, Danny Doring getting his head popped under the going nuts. Anything Norman does, Danny Doring comes with a little bit of a different attitude. The fans pick up on it.
And Palladium ring, and I'm calling for a timeout in wrestling, Danny Doring.
Is that like there's no crying in baseball?
Kinda, yeah, but it's less cliche.
Coming up tonight in our main event, I'm gonna be flying solo on that one. It looks like because Mikey Tenderfoot, you're teaming up. Taking on the arch nemesis preview of some matches we've got coming up August 6th.
Coming to a head, August 6th. Will float over arm drag for Norman Smiley. Arm drag. Danny Doring doesn't know where he is. Another nice arm drag back here. Stops him and dance. Beautiful, Norman Smiley. Beautiful.
I haven't seen anybody dance like that in an IPW ring since the Jag.
You did?
Yeah. Like that?
Oh, not like that.
That's what I said.
It was kind of like a boogaloo.
You never listen to me anymore.
Now coming in on Danny Doring. Danny Doring a little bit here against Norman Smiley. Doesn't want it quite yet. Danny Doring still being a little defensive.
Danny Doring, he's D-squared. What comes to the ring with Danny?
I'm not sure. What kind of deeper do you mean?
Let's not go there, Mikey Tenderfoot.
Wrist lock, Metestas, Doring, Norman Smiley, and Danny.
German Smiley, obviously the set.
Smiley, well in control this match. Sort of like the Jedi mind trick, which I would use.
Of course you'd use the Jedi mind trick. Who? That's why people such as you and I cannot have such a strong power.
Touche. Danny Doring looking a bit reversal there for Norman Smiley. Danny Doring set for a ride, coming back in, gets a waist lock, going for a roll-up. Hits it, one, two,
look the tights, I mean, get the pin.
Able to kick out. Coming in, oh, there's the swinging tornado scoop slam from Norman Smiley.
Well, I know done. He's got to dance now.
I think, yep, he's going for the big wiggle. Here it comes. Danny Doring's in position. Oh, no.
Boy, how often have we said that here on IPW television?
Oh, no. Wait a minute.
What? I knew it!
This is the first here on IPW Hardcore Television.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, very nice strategy.
That's what I meant.
Oh, right. Now, very in control.
Picking the Danaconda here in this match. But I must admit, even though I don't normally go for those cutesy babyface tactics, this boner, too, and this cat right here.
Doring taking over on Norman Smiley. Nice snap there. Oh, and a stiff kick to the small.
If Mimi was here, he would say, that is ball that small.
And then I would go, I got body weight here. Rolled up there for Norman Smiley.
You're in the ring with, he's a veteran. You can time like that. You need to take him while pinfall victory, or you're going to come up on the.
I don't think so.
Perhaps a 90.
It's Aaron Royal. $10 right now, he doesn't do it. To Aaron Royal.
See, he did the axe handle just as I said.
Give me my 10. Hey, give me that back.
You should be more specific with your bets, Mikey Tenderfoot.
You know, if this survivor wasn't here, I'd be whooping your ass.
Yeah, that's very possibly true. But the fact of the matter is, those things are not in your face.
I'll try to do the mime thing for the divider, but it doesn't work. Danny Doring moving.
No!
Moving ahead.
Tell you what, the fan wrestling crowd and fans, we will be back shortly. But our two big shows coming up, as I said, the fifth anniversary show at the Pinellas Expo Center.
Oh, bicycle kick for Danny Doring. Norman Smiley might have just bit the distance.
While he's pinning a guy the caliber of Norman Smiley. I try to learn these guys. I try to even got the win, and you're still out here in the ring.
What are you going to do? Maybe that forfeit. Here's your $10 back, bro. Huge! That could be it!
We go to basics. I don't think Taz would appreciate that very much.
So far, I'm going to get him in that reverse chin lock. Hooked out and lay on the floor and make corporate angels for the reverse chin lock.
All right, four. I'm going to have to call the enthralling. You may think that he doesn't know what to do, that he's just doing it to think up some offense. That's not maybe the more quicker and agile of the two. You've got an advantage if you're Danny Doring.
Back, man, that was a great reverse chin lock. Nice Norman Smiley. Look at him go. And on the run, this could be it for Norman Smiley. He might have hit gold with Danny Doring. He's out of it, pushes him to the ropes. Beautiful delayed butterfly suplex driving him right to the mat.
What was that called?
A butterfly suplex that was delayed.
Beautiful. I would have called it a hooked his arms, him on his back thingy, but yours.
That's pretty much what it is, but Norman Smiley, huge chop there for Danny Doring, whipping him. He has won this match. He has beaten Danny. And here we go. Whipping him in. Smiley.
Look at this pretty face. This is Agent Steele, the man with the issuing an open challenge to anyone. So anybody wants to step in the ring with me, you think you're good, I'm going to show you what's up. You see, because I've been around here for about 3 years. It takes a simple paperwork. Guys, hand it up. JR Ryder. It could be you, CBG. That.
Billy, who's my spot? Come on. You can over again. It doesn't matter if it's more. This is only airing up in Canada. It's just a little bit smarter.
I can't
That's
say
right.
more.
Yes, you can. You can do it. Who's my star? Who's my star?
You know what? You got one more shot. One more.
Okay, all right. One more. Get it off the bat right now.
The Moorhead Vitamins. They can do it for you too.
Python taking on the big man.
First foray into the hardcore world. His partner Axis and go real hardcore.
It's Mideon.
Mideon walked away.
That's not Mideon.
No. There's.
Look at Jack for this, I must say.
Yes, he is Mideon in some of the best shape of his career.
I'm not sure how well that's going
to
work with him.
And the way they come to the ring, try to strike out.
Now that's justice.
For Mideon, we know that she's been being her alliance as well.
I think he's really happy about this. Luna's been a veteran, knows what to do to get the job done for her, man. Mideon now
Okay, Luna Vachon definitely up from the headliner, if you will, that he had with him at Ring City a few months back. And oh, look at that. He told Coral, Lennox, and Axis in the back he's going to come out here and handle Mideon all alone. He wants to prove.
A reversal into the corner. Nice hard coming right out after the hardcore champion.
Hardly keep up with this action like this. Going all crazy, which if they want, there are no
over the palladium and going at it right against the glass. It's like a hockey fight, baby.
It's just like a no next.
Yeah, I was gonna say that. But
anyways, Python right now, we talked about that. Mideon coming out, and when it went inside the ring, there he goes right there. Normally, actually turn away from a referee, like to get in on the action, chopping Mideon.
Our first foray, as you put it, into the.
Never count them out for long. Some smaller guy right in you. And look at that, throwing Mideon.
IPW Hardcore Champion.
Count here, no. Mideon is
interjecting herself, if you will, here on the mothership, baby.
Yeah, she just throws that chair right across the back of that. Python didn't quite get in there with stepping.
It's not going to stop her interference now. Python's got to deal with not only IPW a champion, but also Ludovic getting a cloak hand right to the head.
Maybe haven't seen anything quite this wild in it, but just in awe of what's going. They certainly do not.
Out of the ring in that first row, the fans are absolutely shocked and horrified. And oh, and a chair right to the
Wrestleplex and a hardcore title back up the ranks and ready to reclaim.
Python back into the ring. Python, all kinds of what
kind of look like Boris Zukov.
Way in the double fist drop. I am shocked, amazed, and all other kinds.
A little too quick and a big elbow right there by Python. Oh, huge
club. IPW Hardcore Division. Nice. That's a bit in his hand. Oh, and absolutely some. That's legal.
That's legal.
Can grill.
You had to know game.
Can't grill. Absolutely taking it out. Nice maneuver for going to pick him up. This match will retain his titles. We'll be back with more.
Coming at you right here, fan. My normal partner, Mikey Tenderfoot. He had to bail out. He's headed to the ring with his partner, Super 8, if you will, Sedrick Strong. And as you heard Evan 9 say, led to the ring by SoCal Val. And before you ask, yes, he is indeed related to Billy Fives. There goes Val. You see, Mikey, he can do it all. He comes in here. He was the top referee in the business. He's a great broadcast partner, whether I like to admit it or not. I may not like his recent choice of friends and going against the AOD, who now even he has no respect for. But you got to give this kid credit. As good as he is at everything else, he's even better inside that ring. And they're going against Rod Steele and Roderick Strong. You heard their promo at the top of the show, and they were absolutely right. These two guys owe their careers to these guys. Rod Steele, he took Mikey Tenderfoot from the mid-card and brought him to the top. And Sedrick Strong would be stuck in some sand pit in Central Florida if not for Roderick. But did they show any respect? Hell no. All right, and there I was waiting for Mikey Tenderfoot to take over and cut me off as he usually does. But as you see, he's about to be in the ring wrestling, so he cannot do that for me. Look at Rod Steele, the former Rod Damn Champ. Always a Rod Damn Champ, in my opinion and in my heart. He was just out there toying with Mikey Tenderfoot. And there you see Roderick Strong, serious as always. He really just wants to beat the living hell out of his brother Sedrick. And any of you who've ever talked to Sedrick Strong for more than 2 minutes can certainly understand why. Oh, was that for me? All right, fans, this is a tremendous main event. But before we get started, I got to tell you about some of the stuff coming up next week. In our main event, Billy Five defending his heavyweight title, IPW heavyweight title, against Frankie Kazarian and two other guys very interested in that match. They're going to wrestle earlier in the night next week for the number one contendership, the AOD Scoot Andrews and Rage in the Cage 5 winner, Lex Lovett. Add that to the three-way for the cruiserweight title, and next week is certainly one you do not want to miss. The two top cruiserweights in their own right, in there right now, Roderick Strong and Mikey Tenderfoot feel each other out. A couple of monkeys flips going on there, and there Mikey Tenderfoot getting the best of it. A little bit of a strength advantage there on Roderick Strong, which I must say is a bit surprising. Normally, you see Roderick Strong coming in here taking the advantage with the Roderick Strong style, but right now, Mikey still has the advantage. But Roderick doing what he does best, coming in there and breaking body parts as he just rips the arm of Mikey Tenderfoot across both shoulders, and now a series of arm drags by both individuals. Oh, and double drop kick. Both guys back up, and the fans giving the props. What a tremendous series of maneuvers. Maneuvers you can only see here in IPW. And referee Billy the Kid, mysteriously without his new manager, whatever the hell's up with that, Fritzy. But both guys tagging in their partners, and there you see Rod Steele in there against Sedrick Strong. Let's see your Super 8 skills come to life now, pal. And there you saw a beautiful, beautiful shot of the lights that either Sedrick Strong or Mikey Tenderfoot will most likely be looking up at later on in this match. Oh! Clubbering going on there, some right hands by both individuals, but Sedrick had gotten the better of it, but he's whipped off the rope by Rod Steele. Rod Steele dropping down, Sedrick up and over. Oh, going for the leapfrog with Rod Steele, but instead a knee to the McGroin and a kick right to the midsection. Oh, and a neck breaker by Sedrick Strong. His brother may be the back breaker, but that had to hurt Rod Steele right across his neck right there. Oh, Rod Steele catches him in midair, and I have no idea what that maneuver was whatsoever, but it certainly looked very, very painful indeed. Rod Steele smartly bailing out of the ring. I tell you what, he loves to play mind games with Mikey Tenderfoot. He ain't scared of Mikey Tenderfoot. That ain't the case. He just knows Mikey is not himself in the ring. I love Mikey to death, but you can even tell when he's out here talking about it. When it comes to Rod Steele, he cannot keep his head about him, and that's going to cost him in this match, in this feud, and indeed in his career. See, what you hear now, fans, is one side of the arena chanting Mikey, but the other sound, not Mike, is saying he eats anything. Roderick Strong from Cocky Top Mountain, Tennessee, wanted to go test the strength there with Mikey Tenderfoot. He doesn't believe for a second that that was anything but luck, that Mikey got a strength advantage on him earlier. And let's see, we're going to find out right now. They're going at each other mano-a-mano, as Ford Fairlane might say. Oh, almost a pinfall there. Oh, look at this, right up. I do another pinfall attempt there. Roger Strong and Mikey Tenderfoot, but Mikey able to kick out. You're not going to get a guy Mikey Tenderfoot's caliber that easy, but you've got to go for it. Look, Mikey tried to flip him over. Roger stopped him. Mikey flipped him over anyways. These two guys, as Ron Nemi would say, a counter for every counter. Put some knees right to the head, but you can't get him a third time. Oh, and a kick right to the back of the head. Mikey Tenderfoot taken back over in this match. Nice standing Hurricane Rana and smartly tagging out to Sedrick Strong. Both guys whipping Roderick off the ropes. Oh, right on his back, Roderick Strong. And you can't be breaking other guys' backs when you're flat on yours. Oh, and some miscue by the AOD, baby. What's going on here? You guys got to get this together. Scoot and Mike and Agent Steele can't be liking this very much at all. Oh my God, taking out both guys on the outside of the ring, up and over the top rope, Sedrick Strong. And oh, Mikey Tenderfoot sneaking up for some chicanery and tomfoolery and some plain old horse fooling around of his own. Oh, spiral type maneuver there to the outside, knocking down every individual out there. And this crowd a few months ago couldn't stand Mikey Tenderfoot when he was a referee. Booed his entrance coming to the ring. Back when he was a respectable individual, calling everything straight down the middle. Now they're eating this kid up. They can't get enough. It just goes to show, if you're in there against the AOD, who the fans have no respect for because they just don't understand, you're going to get the cheers. But as I'm talking about that, Sedrick Strong taking over on Roderick Strong. I've got to give him some credit. These two guys were in our main event back on July 4th weekend. Neither guy can get the better of the other as they knock each other out on the ramp. And here comes one of the backbreakers from Roderick right across his knee. And I tell you, once he starts wearing down that back, it's very, very certain to be lights out for the guy across the ring. Another backbreaker by Roderick Strong, and again, holding him right in that same maneuver, just dropping him across his knee. And look at the welt forming on the back of Sedrick Strong. Super 8, that tough guy. Oh, and slams him right down on his back. Hook the leg, get him away from the ropes, and the AOD will get it on the next pinfall attempt, I can guarantee it. All right, Roderick trying to slow down the pace just a little bit. He knows Mikey and Sedrick both like to keep the pace fast. Roderick, he can go that style, but as I said earlier, he likes to go that Roderick Strong style. Slow the match down, and look at those chops. His chest is soon to be the same shade of red as his back, but that would have to be better than the incredibly pasty white version we're getting shown right now. Oh, Rod Steele always a step ahead, stops short. Elbow right across the back and cradle suplex there on the already injured back of Sedrick Strong. And you heard the word. Mikey Tenderfoot had been calling this match. It would be over now. This is with a clothesline. This is with another. Oh, and these two guys playing little cutesy spinning around games there. Oh, but taking a page out of his brother's book. Neck breaker across the knee, neck breaker across the shoulder. And Sedrick Strong has bought himself some time, but if he can't get his carcass up off the canvas, it will matter not at all. Oh, went for the spear. A very sloppy spear at that. Obviously, Winded should have gone for the tag of Mikey Tenderfoot, but he wanted to get in there and get some revenge on Rod Steele. It ain't gonna happen in this lifetime, baby. And he gets him over in a Texas Cloverleaf maneuver there. Reckless Youth coming in, winning the Peterson Cup. Obviously rubbing off on one Rod Steele. He saw how effective that maneuver was against Sedrick by Reckless Youth in that tournament. And he's trying to repeat some of that same magic. Oh, beautiful double team maneuver. Slingshots him up. And then a clothesline by Roderick Strong. And referee Billy the Kid, without Fritz at ringside, can't even tell that there was no tag. Cedric Strong, absolutely dead weight out there. And another version of a backbreaker by this absolute, I'm going to go ahead and do it. I'm going to go ahead and rip off somebody else. This guy is absolutely a crippler inside that ring. Oh, and look at that. He is choking him with his very own arms. That's not quite as good as when the Shea Brothers make people double clothesline themselves, but this is pretty good. Mikey Tenderfoot has not been in this match in a long, long time. And look at the control that Roderick has over Cedric. Just able to make him stand up there. Look at that version of the backbreaker. Bringing it down right across his own crossed legs there. Much like I sat in kindergarten, Indian style. Roderick looking over the corner, asking the veteran Rod Steele if he should finish him off or if they want to punish him some more. And obviously they want to punish him some more. It's like I said, if you talk to Cedric Strong at all, you want to do the same thing, believe me. Oh, and look, he thinks he's Norman Smiley out there, giving a little bit of wiggle, and it actually seems to have brought him back to the game, but no, Roderick able to come right back. Mikey trying valiantly for the tag, but not able to quite reach as he had to hold on to the dreaded tag team rope. I believe what Mikey was trying to say was make some noise up in this. Wait a minute, I'm rooting for the other team. Oh, but a tag there by Cedric Strong. Mikey Tenderfoot, huge flying body press on the top turnbuckle, and some elbows right to the head of Rod Steele. The unique offense that you see picked up from all the tape watching of Japan. Oh, it was going for, it looks like a hurricane out of there, but turned right into a pile driver, a la something Billy Kidman might do. Oh, what's Rod Steele got going there? I have no idea because the camera diverted to the outside. Oh, here he comes again. Maybe they'll cut away again. No, we got to see it that time. Beautiful power bomb there. Hooking the arms for the last second with Rod Steele for some maximum force, not allowing Mikey Tenderfoot to get that base under him by spreading out his arms. And Rod Steele still firmly in control of this match. I tell you what, Rod, just pin the guy. We'll go get our beers, go get our hole, and get the hell home. Mikey Tenderfoot valiantly kicking out. Rod, I'm telling you, you've got to hook the leg, brother. You've got to hook the leg. You've sat here and called matches with me plenty of times. You should know that, big man. Both men up on the ropes there. Oh, Mikey fighting out of it. Oh, and a punch right to the jaw of Rod Steele, knocking off the turnbuckle. I thought he was done for there. All right, fans, he's calling for it. If he hits this, this is absolutely beautiful. Matrix dropkick. Look how long he hangs in the air. I may not be rooting for him, but you have to absolutely hate wrestling not to mark out for a maneuver like that. And how Rod Steele is standing, I'll never know. DDT by Mikey Tenderfoot. I may not like it, but if he keeps this up, despite the Ricky Morton-like bandana on his arm, he's going to get the win. And look at Cedric Strong just laid out outside the ring. Just like he did in that match where they both got knocked out. Roderick Strong, after a while, absolutely manhandling Cedric. Another DDT off the top there. These guys just tearing each other apart in and out of the ring. And ironically, again, if Mikey Tenderfoot was the ref. Oh, but I digress. Cedric and Roderick making their way back into the ring. Now we've got all four guys. AOD in trouble. Oh, but no, reversed. What do we got going on here? Oh, beautiful double suplex. All right, what's he got going on here? Oh, there it is. Deep dicking by Rod Steele. Boy, how many times have you heard us say that? Not necessarily in the match. Oh, and he hits it with the South Beach Slam. One, two, three. That's it, but wait, we got a submission. Roderick is actually tapped. That's exactly right. He wasn't tapping out. He was saying, the match is over, brother. Let me up. Let me up. You're winners of this match. The Alliance of Defiance. It's Roderick Strong and Rod Steele. Fans, tremendous lineup next week. World title matches. Be sure and join us right here for IPW.